Hello guys, welcome back to the new episode of Road to Redis. In this episode, we will be learning about a Redis benchmarking tool. So Redis benchmarking tool is the tool which is provided by the Redis itself, which used to check the performance, or we can say the measure the performance of Redis server. So let's directly jump into the Redis terminal to see how this Redis benchmark tool works. So first of all, we need to open a Ubuntu WSL first, and then we need to open the documentation of Redis benchmark provided by Redis itself. So we can see that the Redis benchmark comes with a variety of options. So let's explore how these options works and what are the usage of these options. So first option, as we can see, which is host. So what is a host name? Host name is the IP address on which your Redis server is running. In our case, we will be using a default Redis server, which is connected on our loopback IP, which is 127.0.0.1. In your case, maybe your Redis is running on some other machine, so you need to provide the specific IP of that machine to connect with your Redis server. The second is port. What is a server port? In the default case, the server port of the Redis server is 6379. If your Redis server is running on some other port, so you can directly pass that port in this command. So let's start typing the command in a Ubuntu terminal. So Redis benchmark, and then let's provide a host. Let's say we have some other host. So let's see how we can pass the host. So in our case, our Redis is working on the default IP. If we don't provide it, it connects directly to the default IP. Then let's pass the port, which is 6379. Now we can see that there is a second option, which is socket. The socket is a Unix server socket file, which we can pass as well in our Redis benchmark command, which will directly overwrite the host and port setting. Now the fourth is password for Redis authentication. If you have set the password in the Redis authentication, for example, you can set the password that whoever is connecting to your Redis server to get the values from your database, it should pass a password. So if you have any password, you can directly use -a and just add the password or type the password here. Then the benchmark will work on your Redis server. So in our case, we haven't set any password. Now, the fifth is clients. What are clients? Clients are the parallel connections which are connected to your Redis server. For example, if you are testing a Redis server and you want to test it with some amount of load, that for example, if 400 or 300 clients get simultaneously connected to your Redis server, so what will be the performance of your Redis server in that case? So this benchmark tool helps you in that. So you can just use this option -c, and then you can just pass, if you don't pass the value, the default value is 50. So let's pass 100. Now the other sixth option is the request. The requests are the total number of requests in total, not by the single client sending that request, in total requests coming from the specific number of your clients. So let's say the nth number of requests, let's say we want to send a multiple amounts of requests to see how our Redis works in that pressure, or we can say the load. So let's say we will be sending 10,000 requests to the Redis server. The D option is the data size of the value in bytes. Let's take an example. We are storing a packet in our Redis server. So we know that our packet size will be 512 bytes. Let's assume that. So we can test that as well with that much amount of data size. But now in R, if you don't pass any value, you will be seeing the default value is 3 in the size of bytes. Now another option is DB number. The DB number is the DB in which you are planning to test it, because there are multiple number of DBs in which you can store multiple number of keys and values to in Redis server. So if we are not passing it here, because default we will be using a 0. Now another option is hyphen k. What is k? It's like a boolean value which tell that if you are not passing any value, it will make sure that our Redis connection is connected or not. If our Redis connection goes down, so then this boolean value come into an action and let us know that our Redis connection has been robbed. So we will be setting it as a default 1, because during the benchmark we need that our Redis stays connected for the time being our Redis benchmark is running. And the reconnect is if the server goes down, so try to attempt the reconnect. Now the key space length. So the key space length is the random keys, like for example the random values, or we can say the how many random values we need to test with. It's just the option to test with the randomized values to have the more better results. Now the other option is pipeline. So the pipeline is the request, like a pipeline is the batch request, sending a batch request to our Redis server. For example, our server, which consuming a Redis, send a lot of multiple requests to the Redis server, and we want that instead of sending requests one by one, we send requests in a form of batches. That instead of sending one request then waiting for the response, we send 5 requests together and let's wait for the response of those five requests as we have sent to the server. The hyphen q option is the quiet. It will just show you the query per second value. Then if you want a CSV output, you can use --- CSV to output the result in a CSV file if you want to share that file with someone else. Then -l is the loop. Run the test forever. Like you are running the test again and again, again and again, again and again to test the, we can say the load test the Redis server, that how our Redis server perform in the continuous request coming in, and the Redis server needs to send the response back. So this is just for the, we can say the more stress testing. Then there is -t. So the -t is specifically I will be telling you about. -t is that on which command you want to run the test. For example, I want to run the test on set, comma, and let's say l push. So it will just benchmark these two commands instead of running benchmark on all the commands. If I will not provide -t option, then it will run benchmark on all commands. In the end, the last option is -i. -i is the idle mode, which just open the connection and stays there and wait for it, that connection is open and see that the connection is working fine, it will not, it's not getting disconnected again and again. It's just that's, we can say, the benchmark, like the reliability of our connection with the Redis server. So let's try to press enter, because we have already written the Redis benchmark with the host port, client number of clients, number of requests, and the number of test cases, the name of the commands on which we want to run our test. So let's press enter. So we can see that the set command, 10,000 requests completed in 0.06 seconds. That's impressive. And there were 100 parallel clients, 3 bytes per payload, because we haven't provided any byte size. So the default value is 3. And we can say that the multi-threaded, we are not using any multi-threaded model. And if we see that how many requests can a set command can perform per second. So it can perform 172.413 requests per second can be performed by a set command. And same as for the L push. So this is how we can see the extra information. For example, if we use, let's say, hyphen Q. When we pass the hyphen Q, we can just see how much number of the total set queries can run or request per second and L push request per second. Other outputs will be not shown to you. That's why it's called a quiet mode, because sometimes we are not interested in all the details. We just want to know how many requests can be processed by our Redis server. So this is how the Redis benchmark tool work, and it's really helpful when we need to benchmark our Redis server before deploying it to our production servers or production environments, and to see how the Redis server can perform in a multiple clients, multiple requests, and multiple amount of, we can say, parameters which are provided by the Redis benchmark command. I hope you guys have enjoyed this video and learned a lot about of a benchmark tool provided by Redis. So guys, you can directly go on your Ubuntu terminal or any other Linux terminal on which your Redis server installed and try the benchmark command and see how the benchmark command works, because practical or the practice makes the man perfect. Thank you guys for watching my channel. Subscribe.